Hi everyone, welcome to the Soul Song. My name is Nina and thank you for clicking on this video. So I felt called to do a reading about how we can bring more joy into our lives, okay? Some of us may be going through some challenging times and maybe this reading is going to help you see things in a brighter light. Maybe it's going to give you some sort of hope, or it's going to perhaps lighten your spirit, even if it is for a little while. Okay, so I have 4 piles here and I have some channeled messages for each of the piles, and for some reason I got some extra cards out there, so I am taking that as a message for the collective, for all of us. And I believe that our guides want to help us through this reading. So let's see what comes through. I'll just go through these cards initially and see what we have. Invocation, okay. So I always see this card as it's almost like an invitation from spirit to invoke spirit, okay? So this is bringing in all the elements of fire, earth, water, air and ether, and allowing spirit to connect with you and invoking spirit into your life. This could take place in any form. It doesn't have to be like an altar or something that you, some sort of ceremony that you do, but I feel like spirit really wants to connect to us at this time, and it's almost calling us out of our little caves and sanctuaries to come out and be more in communication and be more free-spirited, okay? And this is also a great way to get direct messages from spirit. So also what I'm being called to say is that spirit likes big initiations. It likes big gestures, okay? So don't feel like you're doing something weird by maybe lighting up a candle and trying to get in touch with spirit or your guides, okay? Trying to get messages, be it through tarot, through oracle cards, whatever it may be. Don't feel shy to do that, okay? That is what I'm getting here. Imagine and go the distance, okay? So what I'm hearing is limitless imagination. Let your imagination run wild when it comes to expressing yourself, your creativity, your ideas, and everything that you feel passionate about. Don't be afraid of going the distance when it comes to your imagination, okay? Wow, this is so synchronistic. Just today I was hearing a track that was based on imagination, and this is beautiful. This is a beautiful sign to me from spirit that you're on the right path, and only your imagination is going to stop you, okay? So let your imagination run wild and let's see where it takes you, okay? So that is the message that I'm getting for all of us. Now we'll get into the reading for everyone, and I'm going to start with group number one. You can select the piles based on your intuition, okay? All of them have more or less the same amount of cards, maybe a little different here and there, but you know what to do. If you need more time, you can pause the video here, or I'll see you in your reading, okay? So it's group 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right. Hi group 1, for those of you who've chosen this pile, let's take a look at your channel message first. It says, I surrender to the bigger plan. So this is spirit telling you that one way to connect with your inner child and with joy and the spirit of life and zest for life is to surrender to the bigger plan. Okay, know that the universe has your back and that any challenges you may be going through are temporary and it's all part of the bigger picture, the bigger plan. Okay, so let's take a look at your cards. I'm going to start with the tarot cards. Okay, King of Cups. So you're a really creative, sensitive soul, okay? It's time for you to express your emotions. And for some reason, I'm feeling that you're frightened of something. It's almost like you're seeing something at a distance. It's appearing in your life. And it's a bit frightening for you. Is this some sort of change? I don't know, but it feels like you're looking at something from coming towards you from a distance, and that is sort of it's it's a little frightful, fearful. Okay, it's a little how do I put this? Unsettling. That is what I'm hearing. Okay. The Hermit. Yeah, so I feel like it's also time for you to come out of your cave. Okay, I feel like spirit is asking you to be more expressive and don't be afraid of, maybe you're afraid of people or socializing and it sort of gives you anxiety. That is what I'm feeling here. And you have been in your cave for quite some time. It's time for you to come out of it. It's time for you to interact more with other people. And that, you never know what that leads to, okay? Maybe that's what's going to bring more joy into your life, okay? And trust that it is all part of the bigger plan. We have the Ten of Swords, okay? So you have been going through some deep sorrow, some deep I'm hearing unrooting, something that has threatened your very roots. Okay, what do I mean by that? I mean your foundation. Okay, I mean where your place basically in the world, in society, in where you are. Something to do with your security, maybe your home and finances. Something that has uprooted you, okay? That is what I'm hearing. And uprooted from reality. I feel like you've been in a really dark place for quite some time and it is really time for you to come out of that. And accept things for what they were and realize that it's all behind you, okay? And that now you can move forward from here. So, like they say, when you're at your lowest, the only place or the only way to go is up. So, might sound a bit cheesy, but that is what is coming to my mind. You're at the end of this cycle, so I guess this is where I felt that fear from in the beginning of the reading. But the good thing is that you have a lot of love to share. And you're a really deep soul. Someone who thinks a lot about other people. Who is really giving. Someone who is like a solid support system for anyone who needs them. And this may have actually even led you to feel betrayed by other people, but it's time for you to come out of that darkness, okay, and embrace the beauty in the world, embrace change, okay, because you really are at the end of this painful cycle. So don't let all of this baggage, all of these thoughts that have kept you down, kept you in the dark, kept you feeling low and feeling in despair. Don't let all of that loom over your head for a long time, okay? Because I feel like you've been through the ringer, okay? And this is part of your spiritual growth, it's part of your journey, and accept that this is part of the plan. Spiritual growth is never easy, and I feel like you've probably been through a dark night of the soul, okay? That's the process. And after that, you're going to feel extremely light and confident and in tune with the universe, in tune with the magic of the universe, okay? So let's see what else is coming through. Look at that, peace. After these changes, you're going to a place that is peaceful, that is going to bring you hope for something new developing, and a lot of healing, okay? I'm getting a very it's like the how nature looks after a storm, okay? So it creates space for something new to develop. That is the kind of feeling that I'm getting from this. So after chaos and conflict, you are coming to a place of peace and joy. This may even be an apology from someone, okay? Someone might send you a message that is going to bring you a lot of peace and harmony back into your life. No place like home. So it's also a time for you to rest, but at the same time, the message that I'm getting is that you carry a home within you, okay? So you don't always have to be at home to feel at home. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? Like, you can be around people who you trust, who you feel good with, you know? You can be around people who make for good company, who are supportive and kind. And you may not be someone who likes to go out a lot, but you can carry your home with you. It's just you being comfortable in your skin, you being at peace with yourself and where you've come in your life, the place that you are in at currently at your life in your life, and just being at ease with yourself. You don't have to be at home to feel at home, okay? That is the message that I'm getting for you. Then we have the sun. Look at that. So that's the new beginning. This is, I think it's Saturn in Gemini or Mercury in Gemini, I'm not sure. One of those two. And this is the next stage after the Nine of Swords, which is a nightmare kind of card. And this is the absolute despair. So there's nothing can go worse after this, isn't it? It's the last stage. After that, all that can happen is a new dawn. Okay? And that is what is happening for you. So also what I'm getting here is that you need to take good care of yourself, okay? Your physical body, and nourish your soul, nourish your body. Treat your body as something that is sacred, okay? Go out in the sun, bask in the sun is what I'm hearing, okay? You may like to read, so if all you can do to take care of yourself today is maybe go to a sunny spot and read, maybe in a park or at a cafe or something, then do that, because that itself is going to bring joy back into your life. Okay, listen to music that is healing, that you enjoy. All right, and get in touch with your inner child. Get in touch with, because your inner child wants you to be happy. It wants you to be healed and strong and confident and really happy. It's leading the path for you, okay? All you have to do is pay heed to that inner child. Then we have Angel of Love. So the message I'm getting here is that you can. Wow, there's a squirrel on my window. Sorry, I got distracted. Wow, it's so cute. Okay, so the message that I'm getting for you is that you can heal your heart. Okay, it's possible. All you have to do is believe in it. It very much is possible. And know that you're enough, you're good enough, and you can get through this, all right? Trust in the bigger plan and surrender to the bigger plan, okay? Also, you could use pink crystals like rhodochrosite or rose quartz, of course, or even green crystals. Anything that has a heart healing energy, that's going to be useful and helpful for you at the moment. And see the love in everything around, every little being, everything that is a part of nature, everything that is a part of Mother Gaia. Okay, that is and feel interconnected to everything around you. That's what's going to bring you more joy and gratitude in your life. Okay, we have instinct and submerged. Yeah, it is time for you to come out of this cave that you've been in. Okay, you've been in a really dark spot for quite some time, and I'm hearing bitter as well. So don't let things make you bitter, okay? All of your experiences have been part of the bigger plan. So know that you can get out of this. And I feel like this inner voice within you is trying to tell you that yes, it is time for me to go out. It is time for me to move past this experience in my life. And that there is something better, brighter, and more beautiful waiting out there for me. All I have to do is take that first step, okay? You are the leader of your life. You are, even if you may have felt really alone all this while, I feel like you had shut yourself off from your friends, your maybe even your family, and you've been submerged in this darkness for quite long. But it's time for you to get out and be do it in small steps, okay? Even if all you can do today is have a great bath and maybe go grab a coffee or read a book or just maybe take a walk out in nature, or just go spend some time on your terrace or your balcony or wherever you find you see a bright spot. Even that is going to help you. Even that is enough. That is the first step that you can take. All right, so that was your reading, pile number one. I hope this was useful, and I hope you found something to take back home from this reading. I wish you all the very best, and I'm sending you lots of love. Take care. Bye bye. Hi, group 2. So let's take a look at what your channeled message is. We have, I believe in the magic of the universe. Alright, so this is about you believing in your inner magician to be in connection with the universe and to co-create and to go the distance and imagine all the possibilities and all the opportunities that you can bring to reality, okay? And also about knowing that there exists an interconnectedness in the universe and things appear in your life magically when the universe wants them to, okay, in divine timing. Also, that there is magic in every situation, even if it may not appear to be so at the moment. Know that the universe is always working in your favor, okay? That is the message that I'm getting for you. You can use that as an affirmation as well. So I'm going to start with your tarot cards. We have the Eight of Wands. Okay, speaking of opportunities, I'm getting travel. Again, going the distance, that is what is coming to my mind. And also overcoming obstacles, okay? I feel like something has taken place in your life rather unexpectedly or too quickly. And maybe you felt unprepared for it, okay? I'm also getting for some of you, things have actually been good, but you felt like felt maybe undeserving in some way or unworthy of them, okay? But know that if that's not the case, if things have not really been working out for you, I believe that they soon will, okay? Things are going to fall into place for you and you may find yourself at the right place at the right time, okay? And you're going to see opportunities appear out of nowhere is what I'm hearing, alright? Look at that, the Page of Wands. So there's a sense of adventure here. Again, lots of travel, okay? This may have something to do with overseas as well. If you have been planning to or thinking about traveling overseas, do it, because I feel like it's going to bring back that joy in your life if it has been missing, okay? For some of you, this is about learning something new, something that you feel really passionate about, maybe a hobby or something that is really creative, something, it could be a pet project of yours that you wanted to be, you know, that you wanted to start working on. Could be something, anything that allows for creative expression that you feel really passionate about. But it's something that also requires a bit of learning and on-the-job learning, you know, or on the go. Learning on the go, that sort of thing. So, I'm getting like things like baking and chocolate making, all of that, even painting, singing, dancing, designing for some of you. So this is what I'm seeing. It could be just about anything that brings you happiness, that brings you joy, just for the sake of indulging in that activity, okay? Just by indulging in something that you enjoy, you'll be able to bring back joy into your life. Alright? Okay. The Four of Pentacles. I feel like you may be a little hesitant to indulge in this. travel or hobby or pet project or creative project, whatever it may be, because you feel like your budget is tight. Okay, you may feel like you don't have enough money to go ahead with this, but spirit is going to back you up. Okay, and believe, again I'm getting a message here that you can manifest that money. Okay, so this is how it works. Just decide. Let's say you want to, I don't know, go on a journey, and you're wondering, how am I going to, you know, have enough money in my account until that that date when I'm supposed to leave. So know that the universe is going to magically bring forth that money into your bank balance, into your bank account. Somehow you're going to be able to manifest that. All you have to do is believe that it's going to happen. Okay, maybe set a date to it. And I have read about some incredible miracles that have happened just by sending out these intentions and believing that they will manifest. Okay, so I read about this girl who didn't have enough money for her dream wedding, but she knew the date that she was going to get married on, and she knew that she is going to, she was confident and had faith in the universe's ability to help her manifest the money that she required for the wedding. She didn't exactly get the money in hand, but somehow things fell into place, and people out of nowhere sent her, they did favors for her. Somebody pitched in for a wedding cake, somebody pitched in for a band, and she got the exact place that she wanted to have for her wedding ceremony. And she also got her dream wedding gown, wedding dress. Okay, so all of that is, it sounds too good to be true, but it actually happens. Okay, you need to visualize and have faith in the universe for that. So if you are feeling like you might want to start something that is creative, that has potential, but you're not too sure about your finances, know that the universe is going to have your back. Okay, and as and when you start this journey and go on this journey, things are going to unfold in a seemingly incredible way. Okay, seemingly unbelievable way, but it's believable. Okay, so what you've got to do is be flexible. All right, like I said, have faith and believe that there is potential here and that things are going to work out for you. All right, I'm also hearing that spirit is pointing you in the right direction. All right, so if you are getting this nudge about starting something new or like something that you're really passionate about, spirit is guiding you on this journey. It's pointing you to the right direction. Okay, so follow your nudge. Look at that, new life. Wow. This is incredible. I'm also hearing that you need to first of all put yourself on the pedestal. Okay, what do I mean by that? Don't let it get to your ego, but know that you're capable of manifesting this. Okay, and it's almost like things are going to appear out of nowhere, and you're going to wake up suddenly and realize, oh my god, this is actually happening. Okay, it's almost like she's woken up from her sleep, and things are going to unfold in a rather quick and seemingly unbelievable manner. Okay, and put yourself on the pedestal, knowing that you're here for the right reason. and you're here because, or this has manifested in your life because you're worthy of it. Okay, you've done the work, you've done the inner work, you've had faith, you've trusted in the universe and in spirit, and now it's time for you to fly. So know that you're capable of handling whatever is unfolding for you. Okay, that is what I mean by pedestal. Not by, I don't mean like worship yourself or anything like that. Okay, and breathe through the process. See, lots of creativity here. This is definitely a creative venture for you. I'm also getting like travel vlogging. If you've been thinking about that, do it. Okay. Second chakra is the sacral chakra, which has to do with your desires and your intimacy, okay, interpersonal connections. And it's also where your creativity lies, where it stems from, where the seed of your creativity sits, okay? That is where new ideas and the willingness to, or the that gut feeling sits. And it's where you get these nudges from, that, okay, I should follow this, and this is full of potential, this is what drives me, and I should do this. Okay, then you have patience, right? I doubt if you're going to have patience with the Eight of Wands here, because things are going to unfold rather quickly, rapidly for you. Okay, but spirit is asking you to be patient. And also a message that I'm getting here is that you might think that, okay, I don't really know too much about this, I'm not sure if time has passed me by, is what I'm hearing. I'm not sure if I should be doing this now. Maybe you're like 40 years old and you're thinking, should I become a travel vlogger now? But spirit is telling you that no, there is no time to learn something new. There is no time. Time is not linear. Time is an illusion, okay? And you are not too old for this. You are not too young for this. Or you are not too inexperienced for this, okay? So, again, believe in the magic of the universe. Strength. You can do this. You can overcome any sort of obstacle that is holding you back, whether this is your finances or your doubts about whether you can do this or not, whatever it may be, you have the strength to go through this, okay? And then we have movement. Look at that, there's a lot of movement happening. So I'm getting a strong feeling that this has something to do with travel or with relocation or with travel being a part of this journey, this project, or whatever it may be. And that is what is going to lead you. I'm hearing follow the sun, okay? Follow the sun. The sun is like your sacral and solar plexus energy. That is the energy of the sun. It drives you. It motivates you. It keeps you positive. It is also connected to your purpose, okay? So, do what motivates you. Do what makes you want to jump out of bed and go for it. Alright? Wow, this is incredible. So, do let me know what this is about. I'm really curious. If you're planning to maybe start your own YouTube channel or something and become a travel vlogger, and you're thinking, I don't know how I'm going to manage the finances, or if you have doubts about whether you're capable of this or not, or you're feeling like, oh my god, I'm too comfortable where I am right now, I'm not sure if I should take a risk. No, spirit is telling you, take that risk, okay? But be patient, and also know that time is also on your side, okay? You're not running out of time. You have you're not too late for this. That is the message that I'm getting. Okay, you have the strength for this. Be like the river, just flow. Okay, so that was your reading, group number 2. I hope this was helpful and useful and gave you some hope. Okay, work on your sacral chakra. Lots of orange here, lots and lots of orange here. You're driven, you're passionate, you're creative. It's just time for you to unleash that potential within you, okay? And be flexible. Even if you do come across obstacles on the way, know that spirit is going to help you take care of them and deal with them, okay? You're not alone. Alright? So, I wish you all the very best on your journey, and I hope this was helpful and useful to you. Let me know what this is about, okay? Take care and all the best. Bye-bye. Hi, group 3. For those of you who have chosen this file, let's take a look at your channel's message. I release and accept that which I cannot change, okay? So, straight away, I'm getting the message that you've been in circumstances where you felt a little helpless and you felt out of place is what I'm hearing, okay? So you may have been quite a stringent environment where you've not really been able to fully accept the surroundings for what they are, because they're not really good, okay? And they've not been conducive or supportive of what you wanted to achieve is what I'm getting. But the first step in getting out of this web I'm hearing is by accepting the things that you cannot change. Because what happens is, and I can relate to this, okay, many a time I have been really down because of the things that surround me and the circumstances, and I felt helpless and I felt like I'm not really able to achieve my full potential here, or I'm not able to keep my spirits high, okay? And that hugely hampers your growth, because it's all about your thoughts, okay? If your thoughts are not great, if your thoughts are not positive, you will not be able to manifest what you want. And in order to keep those thoughts positive, you have to have the right climate, the right surrounding. And if that is not the case, it becomes difficult sometimes to keep yourself positive. So I completely understand. But it's hugely liberating to know when to accept that there are things that are never going to change, okay, in your surroundings, or maybe you're in a toxic environment when it comes to your work or your home or whatever it is, and you feel like things are just not the way they should be. But there is peace and liberation in knowing the things that you cannot change and accepting them for what they are. Does that mean you should accept toxicity? No. But you can definitely distance yourself from it psychologically, emotionally, and be more stoic in a way, and be more focused on yourself, okay, and focused on your self-care, self-love, alright? So shift your focus to the good things, what you can achieve, what you can change, and that's what's going to get the ball rolling. Let me start with the, so I am getting a feeling of being, this is the 9 of Wands, which is the wounded warrior. So you are coming from a place where you felt like you've had to guard yourself constantly and defend yourself, and you've had to put up a lot of work, put in a lot of work into the situation or the environment. And I'm also hearing thankless job, okay? For some of you, this has to do either with your family. If you're a mother, maybe your children are not really being grateful for you or whatever you do. Or however this applies to you, but it feels like you've been feeling defenseless, and now it's like I'm getting the feeling I'm just gonna let it go. Okay, I'm just letting it all go because I can't put up with this anymore, and I can't guard myself anymore. I can't put in any more effort into this. That is the feeling that I'm getting. Okay, so you are beginning to let go of the things that you just cannot change, which is a good sign. All right. And we have the Two of Cups in reverse, so this may have something to do with a relationship, but I feel like this also has to do with you being in touch with yourself, okay, with the better version, the best version of yourself, and feeling inspired by that version, okay. So for you to come into union with yourself, you'll have to first of all accept things that you cannot change, and at the same time work on connecting back to things that bring you joy, connecting back to things that make you feel whole. Okay, what do I mean by this? And just go back to the things that bring you joy personally. And what are those? These could be your... I keep hearing whole and complete. For some reason, I feel like you're not feeling complete or whole at the moment. Okay? And unless you feel whole and complete by yourself, you won't be able to attract the person, the right kind of person in your life. Because... then it leads to codependency, and if that person leaves your life, you're going to feel incomplete again. Okay, I hope this is making sense, but I am feeling like you've had some sort of a separation from someone, and you're at a stage where you have realized that I cannot go on like this, and that I have to accept things for the way they are. Okay. Yeah, separation. Someone has definitely okay, that is why I was hearing whole and complete, because you're not feeling whole without this person. Someone has perhaps left you out in the cold. Someone has abandoned you in some way. But know that nobody has the power to abandon you. If you feel whole and complete in yourself, you will never go through this abandonment crisis, okay? If you're feeling neglected, if you're feeling like you're not receiving love, and you're feeling... like this always happens with you, then it's time for you to take that power back and realize that you can make yourself feel whole. You can make yourself feel complete. You can love yourself enough for two people. You don't need any other person to do that for you, okay? For some of you who have been struggling with finances and who have... not been able to create abundance for themselves because you've had like a limited mindset or a mindset of poverty, of not having enough, then that is what stepping out of that energy, stepping consciously, trying to change that mindset is what is going to bring back joy into your life, okay? A leg up. So this is about, for me, this card always talks about spirit giving you a helping hand. This could be in the form of somebody, even a stranger, offering help to you or offering advice. Know that this is how spirit works, okay? Through people, through ideas, through random events, through things that just appear out of nowhere in your life, okay? And very often it happens through people, okay? So when that help comes your way, accept it, because it is going to help you move towards a more positive outcome in your life, okay? Spirit is trying to help you at the moment. Maybe you're not being able to see that. Maybe you're not able to see that there is help out there, that there is a solution to this. Alright? To the sea. Spirit is guiding you all along. You're probably not able to see this. There are 2 sevens here, which to me talks about spiritual growth. So you're undergoing a process which is not easy, but it is going to make you stronger. It's going to help you grow as an individual. It's going to help you evolve into the person that you're meant to be, the better, the best version of yourself, okay? And that is when you'll come into union with yourself. It'll help you feel whole and complete again. I want to read a little bit about that card for you, because I feel like there's a message there for you. Just give me a moment. To the sea. And the sun. Being in the flow, returning to source, recognizing how pieces fit together, a natural pattern of events. Isn't it wonderful when you feel yourself in the flow of life, when events and conditions seem to engage you in a way that is fluid and effortless? This card reminds you that going with the flow is exactly what you need to do right now. Ride the wave of opportunity formed by perfect conditions. Allow trust and faith to guide you forward as you flow like a river into the sea of life. And I'll read the prosperity message as well, because I feel like this has something to do with finances for some of you. Everything seems to work out when you stop scrambling and allow the sea of opportunities to wash over you and wake you up to your most prosperous potential. To get into that flow, you need to address your beliefs about abundance and money. The true meaning of your personal currency lies in your skills, your talents, and your abilities. And most important, your core beliefs. Everything flows from your inner world and is reflected in the outer one. When grateful to serve, you align your prosperity consciousness with a higher consciousness. You can expect miracles. Everything you need will come to you easily. So this is about going with the flow and trusting spirit, okay? I'll give you an example. People in my life who've had nothing to do with tarot or with oracle cards or divination or spirituality or any of this new age stuff have uttered things to me out of the blue, okay? Which is actually not out of the blue, okay? You might just think that way, but this is how spirit works. They have told me things that I would never imagine coming out of their mouths, okay? So that was like a sign for me that I am being guided to take this path, that I am on the right path, and that I should be doing this, okay? So that is an example for you to know that if you feel like you're lost, if you feel like you're not being guided, you're not being directed by spirit, you're mistaken, okay? Every step of the way, you will see signs, you will see synchronistic events taking place, things falling in place out of the blue. But what you need to do is work on your own core beliefs, okay? And use affirmations like, I have a great relationship with money. Money is a beautiful frequency. Money flows into my life easily and effortlessly. I'm open to all sources of money and abundance in my life, okay? And say things like, things fall into place for me beautifully and effortlessly. So use these affirmations every single day and you will change your mindset about money. And I am telling you that personally I can relate to this, okay? Because I have also struggled with my beliefs about money and about prosperity and finances, things like that, alright? So let's take a look at the next card. And look at that. I love how spirit works like this. Woman holding a coin. So you are going to be led to a path that is going to bring you prosperity and finances, okay? It's going to put you back on track as far as your finances is concerned. So don't feel left out. Don't feel like you won't have enough, alright? This might be the person who is going to help you achieve this. This might come in the form of sound advice from someone who is financially independent. Maybe someone who is like an entrepreneur or a consultant or someone like that. Be open to that advice, okay? Then we have strategy. Yes, this person is going to help you plan and organize and put your put down an action plan, okay, for you. And that's the key to your success. I am seeing a lot of maps also over here. There's a compass. Planning is essential, and at the same time I'm getting that you can write down your affirmations, okay? Maintain a journal, an affirmation journal or a gratitude journal. This is going to help you manifest money quickly and come back on track financially, okay? Then we have music, harmony and completion. Look at that. This is beautiful. So at the moment, you need to let go of certain beliefs that are holding you back as far as money is concerned. And I feel like you are also attaching your happiness to your money, which doesn't have to be the case. You can be, I know it's difficult, but like when you're struggling financially, it's really hard to be happy, isn't it? Because money holds emotions also. It is a frequency, it is energy. And without money, you're not able to sustain, you're not able to look after yourself the way and others the way you want to. So at the moment, you need to let go of certain beliefs. That is what you can work on. Work on a journal, okay? And also listen to healing and beautiful music that helps you get in the right frame of mind, okay? That eases your tensions in some way. And for me, this is a huge confirmation that also a message I'm getting is that you can work with the moon cycles. So full moons are great for releasing and letting go. So you can do like a releasing and letting go ritual on the next full moon. But we have a new moon in Libra coming up on 28th, I believe, of this month. So maybe do a ritual on that day itself. You know, write down a list of intentions and send it out in the universe. Maybe go and, you know, dig up a little in some nearby area and put down that list and set the intention that, okay, everything that I want, it's going to flourish, it's going to grow, okay? I'm not saying like write down a list of the things that you want, but write down the list of affirmations, okay, that I just spoke about. And that's going to flourish, that's going to grow. Do something like that. Do some rituals. Also, around the full moon, you will be able to harvest some results of what you're doing right now, okay? Some manifestations will come into place which you've been waiting for, okay? So I love how everything is always connected. Thank you for these messages, Spirit. Your guides are really by your side. They are guiding you. They are leading you to the right direction. Okay, they want to help you, but they are trying to show you where you need to work at this moment, right? So I hope this was useful. I hope you found it helpful. You can even write this down as one of your affirmations. I release and accept that which I cannot change. Okay, so if this is about some restrictions that other people have put on you, let them go. All right, so I wish you all the very best. Group number 3, I hope this was useful and helpful to you. I wish you all the success and prosperity on your journey, and I hope you're able to manifest whatever you want soon, okay? Watch out for that full moon. Take care and God bless. Bye-bye. Hi, Group 4. Let's take a look at what your channel message is. I am what I am. There's no looking back, okay? So you've come a long way to accept yourself for who you really are, alright? I'm getting that you are someone who's who may be seen as quite weird by other people, or you may feel like you've not really fit in with other people and like you don't really belong to a larger group that you are a part of. This may be at work or in your family or wherever, in general, maybe in life. And now you've come to the realization that, okay, this is who I am and I am what I am, and I've come a long way and I just don't have two shits to give to anyone. Okay, that's the kind of feeling that I'm getting. Also, this is Spirit's guidance for you, that don't look back, okay? You have come a long way and it's time for you to really accept yourself for who you are, in your authenticity, in your gifts and talents and your unique abilities, okay? So let's take a look at your tarot. Yeah, see, you have been a part of a group that you feel like you don't belong to, okay? I feel like you have a really unique individual identity and you feel like it's not really working out with other people around you. This may be at work or at school or any other place, but also I'm getting you feel like going solo, okay? Whatever that means, however that applies to you. So this has brought some disappointment and heartache into your life. You're still grieving over certain things that maybe people have told you about you not being a team player or not being collaborative or not being able to fit in, is what I'm hearing, okay? It doesn't have to be that you're not a team player, but sometimes the people around you are not the kinds who are... You don't find yourself being on the same page as they are, okay? Like, you have maybe more creative ideas, wanting to bring forth a newness to the situation or to the organization or to the group or whatever, and people are not willing to accept anything new because they want to stick to their old ways. This happens all the time. But you don't necessarily have to fit in. If you don't fit in with these group of individuals, you can always find people who are more like-minded, who are like soul connections, okay? You are the Empress. So you are a really creative individual, someone who just is so expressive. And I'm also getting some people might be jealous of the way you look, because you're probably someone who's really pretty, someone who's well groomed and takes care of herself, and who's maybe fashion conscious, or you've got things going for you, and people may be quite jealous of you, and they might have said some harshful and mean things to you. But you don't need to pay attention to such people, okay? You are sitting on your throne. Be proud of who you are, and be proud of your accomplishments, and also have faith in your talents and abilities, okay? You're a creative individual. You can design, you can probably do something that is out of the box, and create something out of nothing is what I'm hearing, okay? So you may be a writer, someone who is skilled at maybe singing, someone who is into maybe fashion or beauty, arts, just about anything, okay? But I'm getting a strong feeling of, I'm also hearing, blow your own trumpet, okay? Don't be afraid to be proud of your accomplishments. If you have unique talents, don't pay attention to people who are naysayers, who want to bring you down, okay, in some manner, because they are ultimately just insecure, and they're feeling jealous or they're envious of you. So don't pay attention, and don't be also, my god, there's so many messages. If you are getting into entrepreneurship, okay, if you are going your own way, doing it solo like I was hearing initially, be proud of your accomplishments and your skills and talents, okay? I keep hearing that message because Spirit wants to tell you that you've come a long way, and too long a way, to give a shit about what anyone else thinks. And don't be afraid of blowing your own trumpet. Sometimes we have to do that. Sometimes that's the first step towards being more confident. Sometimes that is the first step towards being noticed as well, okay? I'm not saying be cocky or anything, no. Keep yourself grounded, be humble, like the Empress, but at the same time, don't play small, okay? When someone asks you if you're capable of doing this, if you can do this, say yes, you can. Because you are, okay? So let's take a look at the next card. We have the sixth chakra, Archangel Metatron. Wow. You have your third eye tingling. Okay, you're someone who is a visionary, someone who can see. I'm hearing also see through bullshit, okay? Someone who is able to get past the illusion, alright? That is what the third eye means to me. It is about seeing from your inner eye. Being able to see that which is not really visible. So you're able to see the bigger picture, the patterns in life. And be proud of yourself. You're a powerful, strong individual, okay? So there's a lot of growth and expansion happening currently in your life. And there's a possibility, or lots of possibilities and opportunities gonna come your way. So don't back down and don't look back, okay? Look at that. Speaking of powerful individual, you have the Magician and the Mirror. So you know how to create alchemy between two opposites, between the hot and the cool, between the dark and the light, between what's visible and what's not. You're able to co-create with the universe. You're a really strong, powerful individual. It's time for you to accept that, okay? And just don't pay attention to things that have, or words that have brought you down in the past, because you're way too good for that, okay? Purification. Reflection. The message that I'm getting here is cry it out, okay, if you need to, if you're not able to get past the hurt and sorrow that people might have brought you, or that you have somehow manifested in your life, because you are a quick manifester, okay? So keep that in mind. All these three cards are actually about manifestation to me. So keep your thoughts positive and reflect on what may have brought this sorrow in your life, okay? Reflect on that and do some meditation. Give yourself the time to grieve, but get over it, alright? I'm not saying it like get over it, not in that sense, but in order to get over it, in order to process the pain, give yourself the time, okay? And if need be, just wash it all off, okay, by crying. If that helps, do that. Also, again, the message that I'm getting here is, see how you have manifested this in your life, okay? If these individuals are not really right for you, are you somewhere not accepting yourself for who you are? Is that what you're finding difficult to do? Because if that is the case, you will attract people who are not going to accept you for who you are. They're always going to mirror back. Okay, they are going to reflect back to you what you think about yourself. That is how the world functions. That is how the universe functions. If you don't feel like you are capable, like you are skilled, you're creative, you're talented, you're beautiful, then people are going to mirror back all of your insecurities to you, okay? So take some time to reflect on that. And I didn't mean to say just get over it, okay? I hope you know what I mean. Never ending story. And we have exchanging gifts. Look at that. Look at that. You are the only person who is holding yourself back because you keep telling yourself this pathetic story that you're not worthy, that you're not capable, that you're not good enough, okay? And this is how you feel at the end of the day. When you have wings, you can fly. You're so gifted, you're talented, okay? You're intuitive, you're able to co-create with the universe. You're able to manifest everything that you think about. So think positive. All right? Look at this. I want you to see this. Can you see that heart there? And it says love there. And it says yes, no. And there's an arrow mark. There's an arrow in the middle. And you're always wondering, is it... You're going between yes and no's. Yes, I'm capable. No, I don't think so. Yes, I'm gifted. No, I don't think so. Yes, I'm beautiful. No, I don't know. I'm not sure. Yes, I can do this. No, I don't know. No, I don't think so. Yes, I'm worthy of love. No, no. Why would I be worthy of love? No, don't think that way. This is a never-ending cycle for you. Step out of it and claim your throne, woman or man, whoever you are. Know that you have gifts to exchange with the world. Okay? You're at the end of the cycle. This is a number 9. This is a number 10. Which is actually about the cycle that keeps repeating itself in your mind, okay? And that is what manifests in your life. It's up to you what you want to manifest in your life. Do you want to manifest people who don't appreciate you for who you are? Or do you want to work with the right kind of people? Okay, do an affirmation that says something like, hey, by the way, if you want wonderful affirmations, look for Heal Your Life, or You Can Heal Your Life by Louise Hay. Read that book. It has some amazing affirmations that you can write down, okay, every single day, and build your self-confidence that way, okay? I feel like you are a really powerful, confident, beautiful, stunning person. So all you have to do is believe in that. I don't want you to look inside the mirror every time and see, oh my God, that's who I am. Your reflection is not ugly. Your reflection is beautiful. Okay? It is time for you to fly. And accept yourself for who you really are. But before that, you need to take off any masks. Okay? And that mask is just, it's self-delusion. You're telling yourself that you're not worthy, or I don't know, you're falling into this hole of self-neglect and self, I don't know, deception in a way, okay? Because every time you tell yourself you're not capable, you're not worthy, you're lying to yourself. That's your ego. That's nothing else. It's just your ego. And that sucks, but that's the truth. Your heart will never tell you that you're not capable. So, maybe this should be your new mantra. I am what I am. There's no looking back. Give yourself a pat on the back for how far you've come. And realize that you're a unique person with unique skills and abilities and talents, and it's time for you to manifest what you want in life, because you can do it. Just stop telling yourself lies, okay? Reflect on this for some time and purify your soul, purify yourself from all of these negative thoughts and negative repeating, recurring manifestations in your life, okay? So that was your reading, group number 4. Absolutely love doing this reading today. I hope this was useful and helpful to you. Let me know if it resonates. I wish you all the very best on your journey, and I'll see you again in another video, okay? So take care until then, and God bless you. Bye-bye.